Good morning, boys. We will continue the exercise number 4.3, sum number 5. So yesterday I gave that last part alone as a homework that you complete. If there is any doubt, you please call me over the phone. I'll help you. Y square minus 2xy into dx is equal to x square minus 2xy into dy. So it is given in this part. So you have to rearrange the given question in general format, that is transfer dy, that is dx, to the right side. Dy by dx is equal to y square minus 2xy by x square minus, just you have to transfer everything. So you have to rewrite in general format. You transfer dx to the right side, then this multiplication become division of the left side. So in general format, see the power of x and y, 2, 2, so homogeneous equation. Add the power of x and y, 1 plus 1, 2, here also 1 plus 1, 2, therefore the given equation is homogeneous equations. Now you have to replace y is equal to vx and dy by dx is equal to v plus x into dv by dx. So this is very important. Clear this, you know already. Just you have to replace in the place of y is equal to vx, dy by dx is equal to v plus x into dv by dx. So v plus x into dv by dx is equal to this y square, that is v square x square minus 2x square v. I straight away I am multiplying that x into x, x square, this v as it is. Similarly down, x square minus 2x square v. Clear? So x square is the common factor of the both the numerator as well as the denominator. When you take outside, eliminated, you will get v square minus v by 1 minus 2v. So we will get, after taking x square as a common factor in the numerator as well as the denominator, apply the cancellation rule, you will get v square minus 2v over 1 minus 2v. So, now you have to keep x dv by dx is equal to v square minus v by 1 minus 2v. When you transfer plus v to the right side, becomes minus v by 1. So, cross multiply, you will get v square minus v of 1 minus 2v by 1 minus 2v. So, v square minus v, you take minus v inside the bracket, minus v plus 2v square by 1 minus 2v, here x into dv by dx. So, try to simplify. You have to simplify. So, what will be the answer? 3v square minus 2v by 1 minus 2v. 3v square minus y minus x square minus, okay. So, now you group 1 minus 2v into dv by 3v square minus 2v is equal to integration of dx by x. So, just you have to group like this. Now, you have to add and subtract. There is no way to simplify. Clear? So, again you have to check. If at this stage, you can see whether it is possible to integrate or not. If you feel something is coming wrong, then you have to check from the beginning onwards. So, this is the question. This will transfer to the right side. Then this will come to the denominator of the left side. There is no changes. So, you have to refer the question, then you have to see that whether you have to replace everything is in proper manner. Y is equal to Vx, V square x square, here Vx, so 2x square V, denominator also x square minus 2, x square V you take outside, you will get V square minus, which one has missed here? 2V, but I wrote only what? V. So, be careful. So, one is the stage, if you are not able to integrate, you find something is difficult, it is not in integration format. Sir, how do you find out it is not in integration format? Very simple. And most of the problems will come in partial, apply that partial fractions, or if you differentiate the denominator will come in the numerator. So, the most of the problems in it will come only these in these two categories. Clear? So, therefore, you have to check again. Clear? That's why I missed the 2. So, you have to write as which one I left here 2. So, obviously, you should come to know that here 2V, therefore, numerator also will come to 2V. The reason is, see the question 2XY, 2XY. There is no difference in that second term of the both the numerator and the denominator. Therefore, you get only the same 2V, 2V. So, that's what we got some. What is that? 2V. What will come here? 2V. So, we will get 3V. Now, we come over here. What will be the answer? 3V. Clear? So, be careful while you work out the problems. Be cautious of introduce that minus and plus. Because most of the boys will make mistakes only in this part. That's why I left 2 deliberately. Now I am finding that. Clear? So, be careful of before you have to simplify this one, be careful of the constants. If you miss the constant or minus or plus, then everything will get wrong. Be careful. And 2V, so minus 2V minus, that is minus 3V, so it will be 3V. Clear? So, is there any other problem in this one? No. So, what is the common factor of these two? You can take 1 by 3 outside, 1 minus 2V into dV by V square minus V is equal to dx by x. And what is the common factor of these two? You cannot apply, if you apply the completely the square by the denominator, you will not get this answer. You see that when you differentiate this one, you will get 2V, when you differentiate V is what? 1. So, it is logarithmic format. Only changes in where? Minus. So, for which I take one minus outside. Minus 1 by 3, 2V minus 1 by V square minus V into dV is equal to integration of dx by x. Boys, be careful of handling the negative sign. So, when I am differentiating the denominator, 2V is there. Differentiation of V is also 1. It is there already in the numerator. Only thing is we have a problem is only the negative sign. Therefore, I take minus outside. While I am taking minus outside, this will become plus, plus will become minus. So, there won't be any changes in that denominator. Now, you just take 3 to the right hand side along with the minus sign. So, integration of 2V minus 1 by V square minus V into dV is equal to, so this will become minus 3 of integration dx by x. Clear? So, after this, just you have to integrate. It will become what? Log V square minus V, because differentiation of the denominator is in the numerator exactly. Therefore, you have to write logarithmic format. Log V square minus V is equal to minus 3 log X plus log C. So, as usual, you have to simplify it more. There are so many ways for simplification. Doesn't matter, the final answer is exactly what is given in the textbook. No problem. So, you have to follow only your steps. So, if you take minus 3 to the power of x, you can simplify, or you take the right side term to the left side, you will get same answer. Clear? So, anyhow, minus v I bring that minus 3 log x to the left side, minus 3 log x is equal to log c. So now I am applying log a plus log b formula, that is I will get x cube, v square minus v into x cube is equal to log c, log log get cancelled. Then you have to replace this by y square by x square minus y by x into x cube is equal to c. Just you have to apply the cross multiplication, you will get answer. Clear? So very simple, but you have to be cautious. See what I mentioned over here, if you mention any constant or negative sign, you will get totally wrong answer. You are not able to simplify this in this stage. Clear? So once if it is not possible, if you have any problem of solving this day after these steps, you please refer from the beginning itself. Just now I did. Clear? This for experimental purpose, I just leave it to I proceed. At this stage I am not able to integrate form properly, that's why I am checking that my answer whether it is correct or wrong from the beginning onwards. You please, you have to check in this manner. Don't keep it your mind only in this area, you never get answer. Once if you feel that integration part is integration is not able to find properly at this stage, you please from the beginning you have to check. When I am checking, I left 2, isn't it? So after replacing v by 2, then I got answer easily. So that is the reason I left 2. I worked out the problems at this stage, I find some difficulty, therefore I am checking my answer from the beginning itself. So you have to work out the problems in this manner, then only you get more ideas how to solve that integrations, these type of problems. So to improve your IQ, you please, you have to proceed. If you are not able to integrate, then from the beginning itself you have to start to check and find out where is the mistakes. Once the mistakes rectified, see I rectified the mistakes, 2, only 2 I missed, there I not able to get proper integration, integrant. Therefore I am checking my answer, I am checking my answer, I left 2, then I simplified, I got integrant is, that given integrant is able to integrate properly, that format, I got it, therefore I got the answer, see. Nothing is, so what is that y square x y x square by x cube, I am using the cross multiplications, so x cube is equal to these two eliminated, so I am taking x y as common factor, I got y minus x is equal to c, plus or same. Whether the book it is given some other answer also is correct. Don't bother about the book answers. If your procedure is correct, then you will get this answer. Clear? So in the book answer, they will get, sometimes they will keep the negative sign in the right side itself. So you will get different format. Clear? But there won't be any changes. Simplification format may be get changed. But the final, if you multiply, if you simplify it more, you will get same answer in, when you compare with the book answer. You will never get different answer. Compare with this answer with the book answer, you get same answer. Only the factors will get changed, that's all. That is nothing wrong. So be careful while you are working out the problems. Be careful of the negative sign and constants, especially in this exercise. Clear? So out of these 4 or 5 exercises, this is the only one exercise need more time and more practice. So sum number 6, the slope of the curve is given y cube minus 2y x square into dx plus 2x y square minus x cube into dy is equal to 0. This is not a standard form, you have to read it in the standard form. So you have to transfer the first term to the right side. So 2xy square minus x cube into dy minus, be careful, minus y cube minus 2xy square into dx. As usual, dy by dx is equal to minus of y cube minus 2yx square over 2xy square minus x cube. See, power of y is 3. When you add these two power 3, add the power of these two variable 3, so it is a homogeneous equations. Clear? So just you have to group dy by dx is equal to this. Start, you are just to transfer the left side factor to the right side becomes a division. So as usual, you have to replace y is equal to vx and dy by dx replaced by v plus x into dv by dx. Just to replace minus y, v cube x cube minus 2v x cube. Be careful, I just started to work out straight away the answer. Y is replaced by vx, vx into x square, x cube v. 2 is very important. Before the problems I left 2, that's what I did not able to get correct integrant part. Therefore, be careful of the constants. So here what will come? 2x cube v square, because y is y have square, therefore v square x square, already we have x, so x square into x, x cube v square minus x cube. You see, x cube is the common factor in the numerator as well as the denominator. Eliminated x cube, you will get minus of v cube minus 2v over, what will come here? Y square. 2v square minus what? Check properly your answers. Minus 2v, here 2v square, x cube, so everything is correct. Now you take minus inside the bracket. When you take minus inside the bracket, x dv by dx is equal to 2v minus v cube, minus into plus, minus, minus into minus plus, over 2v square minus 1 plus v, this plus will become minus v, again cross multiply. So 2v minus v cube, v of 2v square minus 1 over 2v square minus 1. So simplified now, 2v minus v cube minus 2v cube plus v over 2v square minus 1, x dv by dx. So now we try to simplify 2v plus 2v plus v. So it will come 3v minus 1v cube minus 2v cube, that is 3v cube over 2v square minus 1. So now you have to group 2v square minus 1 into dv over 3v minus 3v cube is equal to integration of dx by x. So what is the next procedure? You have to take 3 outside. So take 3 outside, you will get 2v square minus 1 by 3v minus v cube into dv is equal to integration of dx by x. So as usual, you have to take 3 to the right side. So you will get 2v square minus 1 into dv by Again, you take V is a common factor. How we will try? We will try few steps. 3 dx by x. Now you see the integrated differentiation of V is 1. The differentiation of V cube is 2. V square is there. Only difference in where? Minus sign. So just you have to take one minus outside, you will get easily that answer clear. So you never get any difficult one. So after this I left you with you only, because this is very simple. There is no difficult integrand part is given. So you have to integrate differentiation of V cube is 2 V square, differentiation of V is 1. That is only changes in the minus. So you take minus better outside. Then we'll get answers. Clear? This you have to do it yourself after these steps. It's very simple. So don't make any mistakes. The last sum of this exercise. An electric manufacturing company makes small household switches. The company estimates the marginal revenue function for this switches to be x square plus y square dy into xy dx, where x represents the number of units. What is the total revenue functions? So it is given x square plus y square into dy is equal to xy into dx. Why is the sum number 6? After finding 1, you have one C. So there will be values given passing through the curve 1 comma 2. So you have to replace in the final stage in the place of x by 1, y by 2, find the what is the value for C and substitute in the place of C. Clear? That you do it yourself. Clear? The same model, you do it. Otherwise, in the next class, I will continue the sum number 6. Clear? So you have to complete the sum number 6. After integrating everything, you will get in terms of x and y plus c value. To find the value of c, you supposed to replace x by 1 and y by this. You studied already in the previous exercise, previous chapters. How do you find out the values of constant? By replacing the given values. Clear? Likewise, you have to replace at the final stage x by 1 and y by 2. You will get what is the value of c. Then just you have to replace in the place of c. You will get answer. Clear? Now, sum number, this is 7, dy by dx is equal to xy by x square plus y square. Just you have to write in standard form of the differential equation. That is, as usual, y is equal to vx. And dy by dx is equal to v plus x into dv by dx. So, V plus x into dv by dx is equal to x, y is replaced by vx, x square plus v square, x square. X into x square. So, x square v by x square 1 plus v square. Cancel. So, x dv by dx is equal to v by 1 plus v square minus v. V minus, that is v 1 plus v square by 1 plus v square. Just you have to cross multiply by transferring plus v to the right side. By 1 cross multiply, you will get this format. So, v, you take minus v inside the bracket, minus v cube by 1 plus v square. So this will be, these we get, we can easily cancel. So what will come? Minus v cube by 1 plus v square. So 1 plus v square into dv by v cube is equal to minus dx by x. So this also you know how to simplify. Just you have to write 1 by v cube, v square by v cube is equal to minus integration of dx by x. So 1 by v cube into dx, this you know, when the denominator has only one term, you just you have to separate with respect to the numerator, that is v square by v cube into dv is equal to minus dx by x. So we can eliminate, we will get 1 by v . So what is that 1 by v cube? This you know already. When the denominator alone has variable, reduce 1 in the power. I taught you already, for example, 5 by, that is e power 4. So how do you simplify this one? Very simple, minus 5 by, reduce 1 in the power, 3 into 3 v power 3. So this you know already how to integrate when the variables alone in the denominator other than the power 1. When the power of the variable denominator is 1, that is log. So here will come minus 1 by 2 v square plus log v, because 1 by v is log v. So right side you get minus log x plus log c. Clear? So you have to group for minus 1 by 2 v square log v. So you take log to the right side, log c minus log x minus log v. So you take all the group, the logarithmic to the right side. So now it will become log a log c minus log x plus log v. Clear? So it become log c minus log a plus log b, log a by a b. Again log a minus log b, log a by b, that is x b. Now we will get minus 1 by 2 v square. So you have to convert now v in terms of x and y. So v is equal to y by x. So replace v is equal to y by x. What will come? Y square by x square. It becomes the numerator. You will get x square by y square is equal to log c by x into y by x, eliminated. So we will get minus x square by 2 y square is equal to log c by y. So I told you already, wherever you see logarithm, you have to take e on both side. When you take e on both side, e power this term is equal to e log and get cancel, you get only c by y. So you can leave it as this, or you can take y to the left side, your wish. So if you take e power exponential form on both side, why we need to take e on both side? Because we need to eliminate log. To eliminate log, you supposed to take e on both side. So we will get e power minus x square by 2 y square is equal to c by y. So you can write as it is, or you bring y to the left side, you will get answer. Clear? So don't, if you have to see whether in the left side is exactly there in the book answer, I capital C. So doesn't matter. So this is the final answer. If you write up to this, they will give marks. They will not reduce the mark. Clear? Because they will check whether you did the steps properly or not. Because some of them are kept these two to the right, left side, and minus 1 by 2 v square to the right hand side. They transfer these terms in the left side or right hand side. Depends upon that, you will get some other answer. But finally, you get same answer. Clear? So be careful of doing these problems. So sum number 6, be careful, you started to work it out. Check from the beginning itself, sum number 6. So don't simply write what is written on the board. So be careful, you just work out the sum number 6 in by seeing the previous problems, and you come to know that where will be the mistakes. Clear? So you do the sum number 6, otherwise next class I will teach. So there is no different model is given in the examples. So now we will go to that exercise number 4.4. Exercise 4.4. So this is another one model, dy by dx, that is question number 1. Dy by dx is equal to minus y by x is equal to x. By the reason already I told you, if it is given solve in this differential equation form, then you have to refer the 3 model I set. Separable method, that is exercise number 4.2. 4.3, you learned about that homogeneous equation. Now this is another one method, that is linear differential equation of order 1. Linear means the power of x and y will be 1. That is called what? Linear. So you have to check, but what is that one hints I am giving you, that y should not be along with the dy by dx. So if any variables along with that is y, that variable y, suppose if it is given y dy by dx is equal minus y by, just for example, then you cannot apply this method. This you have to go for either separable method or homogeneous equation method. Clear? So y should not be allowed along with dy by dx. Clear? So x is always with which one? Either dy by dx or with y variable. So you have to keep it in your mind, the variable y should not be along with which one? With dy by dx. If it's so, you cannot apply this method. So for this you have some rules. First you have to identify this general format is dy by dx plus py is equal to q of x. So this is general format. Y is independent of dy by dx. So the y should not be comes along with dy by dx. By comparing this one, you have to find out what is the value of p. P is coefficient of y. What is the coefficient of y? Minus 1 by x. Then what is the q of x? The right side, that is x. First you have to write down what is p and what is q by comparing the given question with general format. Then we have some rules. The rules, first one, you have to find integration of v dx. Next one, integration v dx. And third one, the final stage, y into integration of e power integration of p dx is equal to integration of q into e power integral p dx plus c. So this is the rule. 3 rules you have to follow step by step, you will get answer. That will be very simple one. So compare the given question with the general format. After comparing with the general format, you just find out p is equal to, what is the value of p? Coefficient of y is given in the general format as p. So what is the coefficient of y in the given question? Minus 1 by x. Be careful of minus. Clear? So minus 1 by x into q of x is equal to how much? X. So just you have to find out first one. What is the first point? Integration of p dx. So integration of minus 1 by x into dx, that is minus log x. So you have to take minus to the power of x. So x power minus 1. It will be 1 by x. So next, what is the next step is given? E power integral p dx. So e power integral of p dx is, we found already, that is log of 1 by x, log it get cancelled, we will get 1 by x. What is the last third steps? This is the third step, isn't it? So I straight away, I take this is the third step formula, so I did not rewrite. So just you have to replace y. What is e power integral p dx? Integral e power integral of p dx is equal to 1 by x is equal to, what is our q? X. Into e power integral p dx is how much? 1 by x dx plus the xx get cancel, that is dx will come. So integration of dx plus c, integration of dx is what? X plus c, that is y by x is equal to x plus c. This is your required answer. So compared with the previous exercise, this exercise will feel very simple one. Only thing you have to memorize this formula. Clear? So we will see the remaining problems of the exercise number 4.4 in the next class. Boys, please you check the sum number 6. Clear? So don't simply copy what is written on the board, sum number 6 of the previous exercise. So just you have to work out the steps by steps and see, I missed one negative sign in this problem. You just find, identify and let me know over the phone. Only one by Prasant alone is calling me and he is clearing all the doubts, but others are not turned up. So for which you will get more homework here afterwards. Clear? Thank you, boys.